It's made its home at Channel 10 for 30 years. Neighbours, a show about the people who live on Ramsay Street, has been a huge hit around the globe. And our very own David Robertson sat down with the show's former casting director, Jan Russ, for all the juicy behind-the-scenes goss on creating this TV success, as well as Jan's very personal story.
Neighbours. You know what Mr. Crocker always said? Everybody needs good neighbours. And for just over 30 years, we've had the best neighbours in the world.
Helps to make a better day.
And the woman responsible for most of that stellar cast is Jan Russ. When Jan moved out of Ramsay Street, she was just shy of 25 years as casting director. Even when the show changed address from number 7 to number 10, Jan was there.
There was a rumour that I heard that Channel 7 was so annoyed that 10 was going to get Neighbours that they actually burnt all of the sets so that 10 would have a hard time getting the show up. Is that true?
Well, I'm not one to gossip.
No,
at all.
No, no, no.
But yes, the sets did get burnt.
Okay, so we don't know how.
So we couldn't use them at Channel 10.
Yeah,
so
right.
We had to rebuild again. Yeah.
Everyone also needs a good wedding. And ask any of the over 21 million people who watched, one of the most standout moments of the show is the wedding of Kylie and Jason. But Kylie wasn't always the superstar she is today.
Kylie was such a shy little thing.
Really?
She was very shy when she came in. Mm-hmm. Really shy, like a little mouse. There is that something that happens between the person and the camera, and it's not something you can buy or you can learn.
We've heard that one before.
So is there anyone that you had to fight for, Jan, that you thought was going to be great but everyone else was kind of a bit iffy about?
Chris Hemsworth, who now is huge star. Huge star. I put him into Neighbours, he was playing a footballer. Threw my hands up in the air, and of course Simon Away picked him up, and the rest is history.
Wow.
You're right in there.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Hugh Jackman auditioned for me and I gave him a role in Neighbours and we had the contract, signed the contract, and he was ready to start and he rang me and he said, oh look, I've been accepted into WAPA. And it's something I've always... West Australian Performing Arts. And I said, I understand and I know what it means to you, so I'll let you out of the contract and I'll get another actor to do the role.
Now, I thought while we were sitting in Harold's Cafe, I'd give Jan an audition and see if I could have made it on the show.
Go, there's your...
Oh,
there's
thank
your
you.
Latte.
Thank you.
Okay.
Mm. Oh, that's hot.
Oh, it's hot.
That's hot. That's really hot.
Yeah.
How was that?
Yeah, that was good.
Yeah,
that was good.
Okay, cool.
I might have been a bit OTT, but
you've
got to get it real and believable.
Yeah.
Jan quickly became one of the most powerful people in Australian television. But while her career skyrocketed, deep down, she harboured a dark and painful secret.
Now, I remember going into this brown dark and into this little room and feeling so desperate and desolate and alone and terrified and everything else, and that's where I opened the window and stood at the window ready to jump.
Was it the first time you thought of doing that?
I wanted to.
Why?
End my life, because I didn't know what else. I was just desolate.
What drove Jan to this point was something she never dreamt could happen to her. Jan was a teenager and she was pregnant.
That was like my whole world just was fell apart. I thought, this can't be happening, it's not happening to me. It was one occasion, so I can't possibly be pregnant.
Jan grew up in what she describes as a nurturing Aussie family. Sex was never a dinner table conversation. So when Jan found out she was pregnant, her parents had a difficult time accepting the news. Jan decided she would go and live in a pregnant woman's home in Sydney, and she caught the next train out of Melbourne alone. This is where she found herself standing on that building ledge, facing what was at the time an unimaginable future. Pregnant, single, a teenager, and alone.
I was told, don't talk to the married women when you're going past their wards. Never talk to the married women. We were shoved aside and treated like dirt. An extraordinary time that when I started to have contractions and was in one of the cubicles, and a sister came in and shoved a mask on my face and told me to breathe deeply, breathe in, you know, and shut up. just shut up making all that noise. There's a woman in the next cubicle with her husband and she's trying to have a baby, so you just shut up. And the doctor saying, don't worry, just let her rip. She's just one of those girls.
It was only when Jan's mum came up to Sydney after the birth that Jan was finally able to hold her daughter.
And that was the first time I saw my daughter and held her. And it was the most beautiful experience.
You can see it now?
Yep.
But it was back in Melbourne that Jan's parents decided, for her, the best option was to give up her baby.
The months after that were really hard. I can remember my mother telling me that she could hear me every night calling out in my sleep, tossing and turning and calling out for my baby. And that lasted quite a few months, quite a while.
Years later, when Jan was making a success on Neighbours, she reached out.
And I just made a phone call one day and sort of just said, you know, I've been looking for you for a long time. You know, and she just said, "Well, I'm very happy," and put the phone down.
After months of agonising wait, Jan finally got what she always wanted—a chance to meet her daughter.
And it was just like the part of me had come back. I held her, and that big black hole wasn't as big anymore. You know, I strongly believe that that cord is always there, the invisible cord is always there between a mother and a child. Doesn't matter what happens with the child, that cord is there.
What Jan was missing through all of this was someone to be there for her and say, it's okay. You can be amazing. And that's where Bernadette and the Brave Foundation come in for people who are going through now what Jan went through then. Brave is a not-for-profit organisation providing teens who are pregnant much-needed support.
We are the only national organisation that supports someone in this situation to gain access to education and support opportunities. We are independent of the choice debate, so we serve to exist after the fact. And we also make sure that any teenager that is, you know, just a teenager, that life is a gift. We believe with Brave Foundation, anyone in the Brave Village can smile at someone that's facing teenage pregnancy, and gee, that can make a huge difference.
What did you need in those early moments when you first found out that you were pregnant?
Just someone to hold your hand and say, it's okay, you're okay.
What an extraordinary woman with an extraordinary backstory.
Doesn't it break your heart?
Yeah. The Brave Foundation, thankfully, that is there for teenagers so they don't have to go out alone like Jan did all those years ago. You can head to bravefoundation.org.au to find out more.